Hello, everybody. My name is Steve Ford, and welcome to How to Speak English Challenge 10. So our challenge today is, what invention would you like to see in the future? For a lot of us, it's hard to believe that smartphones have only been around since 2007. So around 8 years. But nowadays, it goes without saying that a lot of people cannot live without their iPhones or their smartphones in general. They're text messaging or sending a WhatsApp message while they're talking to other people, while they're watching a movie, while they're eating. So we're going to look at some technology which is going to be coming quite soon, and we're going to call this taking baby steps. And we're going to also talk about technology which is going to take a huge leap. So, in case you haven't heard, Windows 10, which is about to be released, will come with the capability of using Microsoft HoloLens. What is Microsoft HoloLens? It is an apparatus that you wear over your eyes, and it's like a visor, and it has a built-in computer which allows you to see all of your images, videos, and you're able to actually interact with them. So imagine that you would be able to watch your favorite movie or your favorite game, and you could project it. And not only project it, you can also change the size of the image that you're watching with your fingers. So it's an interactive holographic image. So this is something that is going to be available quite soon, and it's very cutting edge technology. So cutting edge technology simply means that it's something which is very advanced, very new, very modern. Now, just like we can see in many sci-fi adventure movies like Iron Man, Minority Report, and so many others, the big leap will be when we can see all of the images from our computer all integrated into one small device, your computer, your phone, your TV, everything, and it will project a holographic image which you will be able to touch and change the size, and you won't need any kind of glasses. It will just project in mid-air wherever you want it to project. One of the advantages I see to this would be for the classes that I give online, where I would be able to project my image into the living room or the office, wherever my students are, in 3D. Well, maybe you would like to see an invention for the future in terms of transportation. Taking baby steps, these vehicles have already arrived, and a buzzword that a lot of people use in advertising is eco-friendly, meaning something that is friendly for the environment, something that does not pollute so much. So all along the west coast of North America, from British Columbia down to Washington State, Oregon, California especially, they have built all of these charging stations. Yes, they're already built for people who have electric cars. And all they need to do is go to one of these charging stations, they charge their car, they plug it in the front, and it takes 30 minutes, more or less, to fully charge their car. There are some pros to that. It's very cheap. It's very quiet. It's very eco-friendly. The cons, there's distance anxiety, so you're always worried if you're going to run out of power. Run out of is a great phrasal verb. It means that you don't have any power left. Your power is finished. Now, I realize that in a few years, even this video will be so 2015. When we say that, oh, it's so 2015, it's so 2007. This is a way to say that something is obsolete. So in the technology world, when we say, oh, that was so 2008, things move fast in the technology world. As you know, that a computer gets more advanced every 3 months, whereas a car takes a lot longer to become more advanced. Now, taking the big leap in terms of transportation is teletransportation. Teleport to New York, London, Paris, Madrid, Rio, Moscow. You can do it in a snap. Maybe one of the inventions you would like to see is related to food. Taking baby steps, there are a lot of diets, diet pills that are available, but all of them tend to be fads. They don't do exactly what they promise to do for the person who's trying to lose weight. And a fad is something which is popular for a short time and then it's forgotten. Beyond the shadow of a doubt, taking a big leap with food will be when they invent a pill where you are able to eat anything you want and not get fat, not gain a single pound. Another big leap would be a food processor. Let's watch the clip.
Food Creator 1.0. Are you tired of eating junk food, getting overweight? Would you like to have more time on your hands? Tired of not being able to fit into your skinny jeans? With our user-friendly voice-activated food printer, you ask for any replicated food from a wide variety of menu choices. Pizza, spaghetti, noodles, hamburgers, steak, you name it. The time-saving Food Creator will make it for you. With Food Creator 1.0, we use an eco-friendly based nutrient solution called I'm Not a Couch Potato for a completely balanced eating experience. You will save yourself a trip to the supermarket and you'll never have to lift a finger again to cook things yourself. Just say, I want a chocolate sundae, and Food Creator will do the rest by creating a tasty and oh-so-mouth-watering dessert at 40 calories per printout.
So much like 3D printers, food processors could be used to print our food. I know that sounds strange, but they're already talking about printing human organs and things like that. So that's a big leap. And we'll just have to see how close they can make the food to the real thing. Just before I ask the question again, I just want to say that taking baby steps or taking big leaps with technology, which influences all of our lives, is something which makes our lives more convenient, more comfortable. But at the same time, we can't forget to develop the potential of our brain, our heart, and our soul. So what kind of invention would you like to see happen in the future? Something related to communication and entertainment and education? Would you like to see some big invention for transportation? Would you like to see an invention in terms of food? Maybe there's some other invention that you're thinking about. Please leave your answer down below and I look forward to reading your comments. Bye for now.